After 15 years of teaching and coaching in high school and major college football, I came to Cabrillo College in 1970 to join my former UCLA teammate, Hal Mitchell. There was an opening on his coaching staff, and thanks to Dr. Robert Swenson, our president, I was hired at Cabrillo for that fall. I was very happy to join a coaching staff that included some outstanding men. Besides Hal, who had been here since 1968, I believe, there was Don Montgomery coaching, and Gene Johnson, who's being honored tonight also in our inaugural Cabrillo College Hall of Fame. Most of our players will recall the Ten Commandments of football. We stress those very strongly. They were based on axioms that were developed at West Point, at Army, back in the 1920s by Major Charles Daly. They were taken to Tennessee by the famous coach, Robert Neyland, who was a general in World War II. And at the top of the list, my students, our players, will always recall the first two. The team that makes the fewest mistakes wins. And number two, they all recall, press the kicking game. It's here the breaks are made. Overall, it was a very positive experience for me and my family to move to Aptos at that time. We settled down here, our kids went to Cabrillo College, and I worked very hard with Coach Mitchell to develop our football program, along with Don and Gene Johnson. Our first championship team here, our first Coast Conference champion, came in 1972. Several years later, actually it was 1974, I took over as head football coach when Coach Mitchell left. During that period of time, we worked very hard with our county athletes and out-of-district athletes that came to Cabrillo College to develop a solid football program in a tough conference. For years, the conference had been dominated by Hartnell College in Salinas and Monterey Peninsula College. We were able to compete with those schools and go on to the state playoffs. At that time, the Division I were the large schools in the state of California, and Cabrillo College was in Division II, the small colleges. And we were able to go to the state playoffs, not only in 1972, but in 74, 76, and 79, with perhaps our finest team. That team was 11-0 and played Taft College here in the state playoff game before probably the largest sports crowd in Santa Cruz history. As I told our team the following year, we outdrew Willie Nelson and we outdrew Ultimate Frisbee. It was a great experience for me to be here all those years, and I really enjoyed my stay at Cabrillo College.